The fourth trait, great musicians love it. You show me anyone who is great at what they do, I don't care if that person is an athlete, a musician, a salesman, or a florist. Whatever it is they do, if they're great at it, I guarantee they love doing it. Great musicians love music. They love what they do. They get off on it. For starters, they love the feeling of their fingers on the keys or strings or valves or sticks. They love the feeling of that reed between their lips. They love the sound, the rhythm, the chords, and the sonic energy they create. What they really love is the magic of music. They love the fact that they can take five ingredients, wood and metal, their instrument, paper and ink, their sheet music, and that special fifth ingredient called talent, and stir them all together to create an energy that can actually make a room full of people feel things. Think about that for a second. Seriously, is that cool or what? Why wouldn't you love being able to do that? Why wouldn't anyone love being able to do that? Great musicians also love how incredible it feels to get really good at creating something with that kind of power, the power to make people feel. They love the heady feeling of accomplishment and the intoxicating feeling of mastery they get when they finally nail a piece. They also love wowing the crowd and communicating with them and having the ability to express themselves in this very cool and magical way. And speaking of audiences, great musicians love them as well. When old-time magician Howard Thurston was once asked the secret of his phenomenal success, he replied that at every show, just before going on stage, he would whisper to himself, "I love my audience. I love my audience. I love my audience." And he really did love them. Why shouldn't he have? Those people came out to see him. They gave up their time and money to go see what he could do. They made it possible for him to earn his living in a very enjoyable way. And every so often, they applauded him. Why shouldn't he love them for that? When a musician is playing for their audience and feeling love for them as well as for their music, they're sending their notes out into the room, riding on a wave of love. And that love-laden note is going to strike a listener differently than a note riding on a wave of boredom, fear, arrogance, or indifference. It's going to strike them in a whole different and wonderful way. And with any luck, the audience will love them right back. Here's a bonus. Love dissolves fear. Loving your audience will help you to keep any of those nasty performance jitters from taking over. Yes, great musicians love the whole experience of making music. They're excited to have the opportunity to play. They're enthusiastic to the hilt, and their enthusiasm is infectious, both to the audience as well as their fellow musicians. Furthermore, great musicians have deep passion for their music. Passion. That's the stuff that gets them to practice and work hard at their craft, even when they don't feel like it, or when they're too tired, or when they would rather go out with friends. Passion is what keeps them going when they are faced with a seemingly impossible song, or when they reach an occasional plateau, as we all do. Passion is what fuels their music with an energy that you just can't put your finger on sometimes, but which nonetheless lights it up and gives it spirit, energy, and power. Love, passion, enthusiasm, excitement. No matter what you call it, great musicians have it, and they have a lot of it. How about you? Now, this is one of those pieces of advice which everyone says is, oh, so obvious. The problem is that these same people don't do it. They'll go around saying all the time, you gotta love what you do if you want to be great at it. But then, not 5 minutes later, when it comes time for them to go practice, They'll come up with every excuse in the book to weasel themselves out of it, or at least skimp on it. There's always some commitment, always some chore or some other activity that gets in the way. There's that comfy couch in front of the TV, and the car that needs washing, and the internet that needs being surfed, and that cup of coffee just waiting for them at the cafe down the street, and on, and on, and on. Somehow, their music always seems to get relegated down near the bottom of their list of activities. So much for loving what you do. The good news is that even if you feel that you don't love your music enough to spur you on to work hard at it and achieve better, greater things, you can always change that. Love doesn't just come over you, as people often say. No, what comes over people is infatuation, that initial thrill when something is heady and new. Love for what we do is, more than anything, something we maintain year after year as the result of a conscious decision to do so. In other words, loving your music, really, really loving it, is simply your choice. It always has been, always will be. If you want to be a great musician, make sure that you make the choice to love what you do. Those of us fortunate enough to hear you play will most certainly love your music all the more for it.